Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm with the new Kia Sorento 2021 model. This is the plug-in hybrid. It's brand new. It comes a few weeks ago and today I will review it interior, exterior. I try to show you every single detail about this new Kia Sorento plug-in hybrid. Also at the end of this video you will know everything you need to know about this car. Also if you want to see the test drive, click the subscribe button to see the notification when the video with the test drive will come out. Also if you want to see new cars, all the new cars and videos that will come on my channel, just click the subscribe button to see all the notification when a new video will come out. Also I will leave the link in the description to the car if you live in Switzerland, around Switzerland. If you want to see the car, if you want to check out the price and all that stuff, check them out because they are nice. Also you can ask them questions if you want to find out more information, test drive and stuff like that. Also in the beginning we will start with the technical data, then we'll go outside. I will try to show you every single detail on the exterior, then we'll go in the interior. We will see how much space we have in the back and the material quality of every single piece of this car. Now first of all, what I want to tell you is that this Kia Sorento, it comes with a 1.6 liter petrol engine T-GDi combined with an electric motor and also combined with a battery. The petrol engine come with the four cylinders in line. Also the power of the car, it's an all-wheel drive, by the way, four-wheel drive car. It's combined with a six-speed automatic transmission that produce together the motor, electric motor and the petrol engine produce 265 horsepower, 350 newton meter, pretty powerful for an SUV. And also the tank, the fuel capacity of the tank, petrol tank, I know this is really important on the plug-in hybrid cars, it's 67 liter, pretty big tank. The range of the electric, only in electric mode, the range, it is 51 kilometer VLTP estimated. Probably we will have less depending the condition on the road. The battery capacity 13.8 kilowatt hour battery. The CO2 emission VLTP 44 grams. The top speed 193 kilometer is limited, 0 to 100 8.7 seconds. In the front the car come with ventilated brake discs, 325 millimeters. On the rear it comes also with ventilated brake disc, 305 millimeter, a little bit smaller. It's normal and I'm impressed that the car come with ventilated brake disc also in the back, so you have great brake discs. Trunk capacity 809 liters. If you fold down the third row, because this car is a seven-seater, you will have 809 liter pretty much. And then if you fold down all the seats down, you will have around 1,992 liter, probably a little bit more, I should say, because I feel like you have even more space here. I review so many cars, so I have experience on my eyes and I know. Now, the front suspension, McPherson Strut with anti-roll bar, pretty good independent suspension. In the rear, you have multi-link suspension. So those are the most important information. Now, guys, let's talk a little bit about the price and the option. This car is the style version, as you can see right here on the paper. And here in Switzerland at Emil Frey, you can check them out on the internet, emilfrey.ch. I will leave the link in the description as well. It's here in Bern. You can check them out and you can also see the price, because I see here they have a great discount. You can see electric discount. You have around 2,500 discount. The final price will be 72,150 francs. You will probably think it's a little bit bigger for a Kia, but keeping in mind that Kia offers you 7-year warranty, and after you will see this video you will understand in the end why they ask so many money. But because before this car I reviewed the Range Rover Velar, and to be honest I like more this Kia Sorento. So if I have to choose personally, I will choose this one, even though, you know, Range Rover, yeah, stars, they drive that car, but yeah, we have to think about practicality. And also it's even cheaper than the other one. You have more space here, the quality is incredible, and also you have some extra options that that car doesn't have it, but I don't want to talk about that right now. In my opinion, today on the market in this class, Kia Sorento and Hyundai Santa Fe, they are the best quality price offer on the market. So the best deal, in my opinion. I don't know about you guys, this is my opinion from my experience and from my reviews, from what I see every day. So this is a great car. It's one of my favorite, to be honest, in this class. Also, it comes with a lot of options here. I don't want to go too much into detail, but keep in mind the panoramic glass roof, it costs you $1,750. The luxury pack with those leather, Napa leather and all that stuff that I will show you, 1,150 francs. Really, totally recommend you to get that. Metallic color, 850, and then all that options, you can see it right here. A lot of options, guys, we will go through as we make the video right now. So that's the price. I think I give you almost all the information. 2,174 kilograms and yeah, 38 CO2 emission. Efficient class A for an SUV. Wow, that's incredible. Okay, guys, don't forget to subscribe to see the test drive and the new car. Now we will go outside. Let's review the car. Okay, so let's start with the key. Here is the key. Also on the side, you have the buttons to lock and unlock the car. And also you have the button for the trunk, because the car come with automatic lift gate. You have to hold it for 1, 2, 3 seconds, and then the trunk is open. After, you can release it. And if you want to close back, the same story. 3 seconds, hold it, and then release it, and then the trunk will close. Also, you can lock and unlock the car, but the car comes with keyless entrance. That means you can have the key in your pocket. You have this little small button right here that you press it and you lock the car. It comes also with electronic folding mirrors, and then unlock it, press it again. It works quite good and quite fast. 7-year warranty from Kia, so keep this in mind when you review cars and when you think about buying a car. Now we are outside. I want to make a tour around the car, and we will talk a little bit about the design of the car. It's a pretty nice design, to be honest. It's not something super crazy, but it's beautiful. It's remember me the back part of the car. It's remember me a little bit of Lincoln Navigator. I don't know if you remember, years before, I think many years before. It looks quite nice. Really interesting. It's not bad. It's quite interesting and nice combination of chrome design with the color of the car, with some plastic around the wheels. Pretty nice lines and edges and sharp design. So yeah, overall it's a nice design. I like it. I like the bumpers, I like the lights. First of all, what is really important is that Kia chose to use LED lights, also for turning signals, also for the taillights, normal taillights, also for the brakes and for everything. I think you don't find a bulb light inside this car. And also they have a very nice interesting line, the same as on the normal version. LED lights on the number plate. You have the reverse camera right here. The car comes with 360 degrees camera. I will show you later. You can see even the fog lamps are down here, and it's LED light. So how cool is that? Some light reflectors right here on the bumper. But other than that, it's a nice design and it fits pretty well with the car. All-wheel drive style. You can see the letters here on the left side, so you know which version it is. And also here you have Eco plug-in, so you will know this is the plug-in version when you see this writing there. Anyway, let me go forward. Let me go to the mirrors. Here you have a big mirror, so the visibility is great. Blind spot technology in the corner. I like the fact that the mirrors have black glossy inside there, so they are pretty fancy. LED light also on the turning signals on the side, the same color as the car. Down part here, glossy plastic on the leg, and then you have a camera here for the 360 degrees system. Turning signals LED, and then you have LED lights also on the high beam, low beam, all that new system, lightning system from Kia. It's here, so in terms of visibility in the nighttime, it's you don't have to worry. Going down on the bumper, we have the fog lamps integrated, quite interesting here. I didn't see that before. It's integrated somehow in the grille, and they give this nice interesting shape. It's unique, it's nice, it looks good in my opinion. Really modern, really modern. And if we go a little bit forward, zoom in a little bit, you can see also from the distance the way the lights look like. And yeah, pretty nice, very modern. Close the door. By the way, guys, the door's quality, it's pretty similar with the previous version or with the other Kia version. It's quite nice, but it's not something crazy. The handle, you see it before, you have this button.
the normal handles, classic handles, nothing fancy. Also here, around the edges of the window, you have this chrome design that in my opinion look very nice. And then you have these tinted windows with glossy plastic here, tinted windows. That looks really nice. These tinted windows with the glossy plastic look really good. Also in the back, you have tinted window. It looks nice, this chrome. Really nice. And also the roof rails up here, so you can add some extra storage, are also silver in the same color as the car. You have the radio antenna there, quite nice and small. I like very much also this roof spoiler design with the lines with glossy plastic around here, but really sporty. It's sporty design on the roof spoiler. The lights here for the brake, LED light up there, super nice. And if I'm not wrong, here inside, it's the wiper. You have the wiper inside here under the roof spoiler, so you don't have that wiper here, the same as Tucson, new Hyundai Tucson. Kia use it also on Sorento up here, so the wiper come from up down, so it's much nicer, it's much cleaner design in the back right here. So overall beautiful design. I like also those elements, sporty elements here on the bumper. I like the plastic down here, and then I like how they design this part here. I like very much this silver with light reflectors, with this kind of fake exhaust, and then the way it comes with those cones on the other side look really good. No exhaust pipes here, at least you can see it, because the real one, it's under there somewhere. Yes. And other than that, quite nice, quite nice. I like the back of the car. Very similar with the normal version. Where is the normal? Look at this. There is the normal version. It's the same, practically is the same car, almost the same design. Just a little bit of changes on the plug-in hybrid. But other than that, it's very similar. If you want to see the review with the normal version, I already have it on my channel. Test drive, review, everything. Now, I like the fact that they add this plastic around the wheels. This plastic protects the paint of the car in time from scratch, from rust and stuff like that, and it's very practical. Also, if you go up here on the right side, keep in mind you have the charging port. You can charge your car at 11 kilowatt hour fast charging station. In about 3 hours you will have the battery full, so that's pretty nice. Also at home you will need maybe more hours, maybe 8 hours to have a full battery. Going forward, the same story down here, plastic to protect the down part of the car, very useful, very practical. Also you have some chrome design here that combined with the chrome from the upper side make the car look quite good and interesting. If you open the door, I like the fact that it's open also with these plastics here around the edges, and also on the down part the same story. So that means you will protect the door when you hit something, when your kids or whatever come in your car will hit something, you will kind of protect. You don't have to repaint the car again. And also it comes down here, so you don't get dirty on your pants when you go inside the car. So yeah, that's good. Chrome design here, elements on the side. Going in the front, the same story on the wheel arch, the same plastic to protect this area of the car from rust down here. It's very practical. I like it. Now the rims, guys, we have 19 inch rims. The car come with 19 inch rims. The design of the wheels are pretty normal, pretty similar with the normal version, and I think they are a little bit more aerodynamic, because you can see here they kind of full. They are not so tiny and sportier. Maybe they help a little bit with aerodynamic, I'm not sure about that. But yeah, they look nice, they look standard, I should say. Ventilated brake discs in the front, as I said before, and also if I'm not wrong in the back, the same story I tell you before, yes, ventilated brake discs. So overall, if you look from here, from the side, I think they fit nice with the car, and the size is perfect for comfort, it's perfect for economy, and it's the way you should go if you buy the car. Now I like the hood very much. The hood, the lines here on the hood look really interesting. I like it. It's big, it's nice, it's powerful. It gives you that feeling of powerfulness, and it make the car much sportier and aggressive. Also on the windshield, there is a camera. I don't know if you can see it. Camera and sensors. Those are for reading traffic speed limit, for lane assist, for light sensors, and also for raining sensors. So yeah, pretty cool tech. I like also the grille, Kia logo in the front. Here it's a camera for 360 degrees camera. I like the grille very much in glossy plastic with those interesting designs. And I see that Hyundai and also Kia these days try a lot to make those grille much more modern and interesting for the new century. So really interesting, really interesting. Other than that, big air intakes there to cool down the engine to go to the radiator. Also some air intakes here on this area, and then even down here, big air intakes. Here, guys, you have the radar in the middle. You can see this plastic there is the radar for adaptive cruise control, emergency brake, and all that safety feature. So keep in mind, it's down there. Other than that, you have some air intakes here that are actually fake, if I'm not wrong, or not. Fake, let's see. No, they are not fake. So the air will come outside here. It will go inside here. It will go outside there. So it helps a little bit. It looks sporty. I like it. I like the design. Pretty sporty, pretty nice with glossy plastic. Really beautiful overall, nice design. Even down here, some nice interesting design on the down part. So overall, the design of the car, it's nice. I like it. I don't know, guys, about you, but it's not something extraordinary, crazy, but it's still beautiful. I should give it from 1 to 10, probably 8 or 9 for the design. I like it for such a big car. It's quite nice. In the interior, I will give it a bigger note, maybe probably 10, almost 10. I would give it from the interior. I love the interior of this car, to be honest, for what it offers. I love it. Also, look at this. You have automatic lift gate in the front here, like a proper premium car. And here is the engine combined with this hybrid system. Here is the inverter, the coolant for the electric motor. Also, inverter is down there. And then here is the petrol engine, 1.6 liter. And yeah, pretty cool. This array, it's very similar with Hyundai use. They use kind of the same systems, and they work together to make some great cars. And I really trust in those systems. I think they will last many years. They did a great job in the last years. Also, you have huge warranty. Here's the air filter. What can I tell you? Also, the air come inside here, air filter, a liquid, the electronic part. Here's the battery. And yeah, whatever. Anyway, I really trust this system. I think I will bet on this system. It will last for many years. Here you have the button down there under Sorento logo, automatic lift gate. Here you have some buttons to lock and close the trunk, handle, manual handle, huge entrance here because it's a big car. What can you expect? Incredible big entrance here. You can fit in plenty of stuff. I like the fact that here you have a flat floor, some plastic at the entrance, but overall a flat floor here. Also, the car comes with the cables. I don't even need to open it up. It comes standard with those cables. And then you can also charge the car at home with this cable at a normal socket. You will need many hours, but keep in mind that you can do that. Then let me show you also under here, under the floor, you can open this part, only this part, because the car have 7 seats. Right now the third row is fold down. I will show you later. I will put it up and we will see how much space you have. You are not able to look under here, and under here you have just a small space in case something happened. You can put here some repair kit or stuff like that, but very small space here. That's something to keep in mind. But other than that, in the trunk, it's incredible huge space. So look at this, big space overall. Here on the left side, you have a speaker hooks. You have also some storage space here, cup holder storage space for the third row. You have an USB for the third row. You have a vents for the third row. How cool is that? Also another speaker up here. And then you have also this protection for the trunk that I take it out right now, and then you can pull it like this and push it back. I don't know if you know what I mean, but it was really uncomfortable to show you that, so I take it out. But keep in mind that you have that option to have that protection here. Now on the right side, you have a 12-volt board. You have also the button for the second row to fold down the seats. For example, if you want to fold it down, you can do it from here. You can fold down the second seat. The same story here. And then here you have the AC. You can also turn it on and off from here for the third row. another USB, another vent. So how cool is that? Tell me. It's awesome how many options you have here in the back. So great job Kia. I love that. Now, if you want to fold down those seats, press those buttons just like that and the seats will fold down really slowly and nice. Right now this one didn't fold down because of the headrest. If you press this headrest back a little bit, maybe just like that, you will have a almost completely flat floor. And if I'm not wrong, you can even look at this, you can even from down here you can adjust the seats. You can put it forward, you can put it backward, you can put it the way you want it. You have many adjustments and you can see you can have it like that or you can have it like that. So you choose how you want to have it. And you can see how much space you have here on the legs room on the second row. It's incredible how much space you have. Look at there, no center tunnel in the middle, so three people can stay here in the back without any problem with the legs. That was something that blew my mind. Practicality, it's incredible good in this car. Now if you look forward, look how much space you have here. It's incredible spacious, all the seats folding down. I think around 2000 liters, a lot of space. Don't know how can I explain you that, but I think I will never use this space if I had this car. Maybe if you have three kids, you will use this space. But you can carry so many things, it's like a van. I mean, look at here. There you have a van, this new van from Toyota. And look at this. You have half of a van inside here. It's such a big car. It's incredible how many things you can carry inside here. It's crazy, crazy spacious in my opinion, crazy spacious. And you have a flat floor, look at it, you can even sleep here. I love the glass roof, guys, really recommend you to go with this glass roof. Looks so nice, make the car much more brighter and nicer, and it looks just incredible, incredible good. And also from here, from the beginning, you have a flat floor. So overall, super splendid space here, I love it. Now, if you want to put everything back, you have to push this like that and then I need two hands. So let me stop the video. I will put everything back and then we will continue. So I want to show you something before. Check this out. You can adjust from down here the seats how you want. So I will put it a little bit forward. So we will go in the back. We will see how much space you have there. Also, if you can adjust even the upper part, you can leave it more on the back or straight like that. Depends how you want to have it. I will leave it like this because you still have space on the legs, but you will stay a little bit straight away. But in this way, we can also check out how much space we have in the back here. If you want to put the third row up, all you have to do is just pull those things. You need to one a few seconds and you will do it. This is the space. If you have seven passengers, you can see how much space you have left here. Not so much space as you can see here, but it's normal for seven row seats. But for short trips, you should be fine. If you don't have so many baggage, you should be great. Here is a button, press this button and then the seats will go almost automatic in the front, so it will make you space to go inside. And to be honest, here it's a huge entrance on the side, not big, it's a huge entrance. And go inside here, I will go inside. Actually, I can do that, super simple. I'm going inside and I sit here. Also, those seats quality are super nice, the same as the other one right here. You have incredible good quality. You can adjust the headrest, you can put it up and down. Here you can see the stitches and also you can see the design. It's incredible good Napa leather, high quality leather. You have also Isofix. You can install two child seats here in the third row. So it's crazy, crazy practical. I love it. To be honest, I love it. Let me go here, okay? And then you can understand now how much space you I have. Look at in the front, this is the position. And then I still have plenty of space on my knees. So that means I can also put this seat a little bit backwards. So I will still have a little bit of space. I can, yeah, not so much stretch the legs under the front seat. On my head I have like two, three fingers. I'm 173 centimeter, by the way. You have also a nice light here. You can turn it on and off, just like that. Super. Also good quality on the roof. So overall, yeah, not bad, man. Look at this. Not bad, I mean. It's one of the most comfortable seven-seater I've been in. I have USB, I have vents here, I have some storage space. I have quite good, I can stay even for long trips like this. No long trips, 300 kilometers with some stops will be just fine. I like it, and also the quality on the seats, it's wow. If you buy this car, you have to take these Napa leather seats for sure. And also from here, you have this beautiful view on this glass roof that you have to buy the car with. And the quality, it's impressive. Even here behind the seats, it's incredible good quality. And yeah, nice, nice car. Great job, Kia. Kia in the last years, Kia and Hyundai make some such a nice car. Such a nice cars. I love them. Okay, just like that, close the trunk. And now we will continue in here. Let me put this back just like that, push it back, also push it all the way back. This is all the way back, and if I pull this and push, check this out, you can have all over on the back the seats. So you can have it like this, or you can have it like this, the way you choose. So you have only 5 passengers here, you have incredible space. But before we go there, let's talk a little bit about the door. Huge door, huge entrance. As I said before, you have also this privacy protection here, like a premium high-class car. Then you have soft material everywhere here, soft material handle, super nice. Also here, I'm not sure if I can show you, but inside the door, I'm not sure if in the back it is, but in the front, in this kind of snake skin design, you have some LED lights insertion, not here in the front, I will show you later, but here is just this design, nice design, leather here, leather, a line of chrome, leather, leather, leathers, leather here, also amazing quality. Even here, look at it, soft and nice, I love it, I love the quality. Also you have heated seats, 2 position in the back, the button for electric window, some storage space, cup holder, some storage space here, Bose sound system, incredible the quality, it's gorgeous. The entrance, Sorento logo right here at the entrance, pretty flat, simple to go in. As I said, you have a flat floor here, incredible, useful. And also you have this button to move the seats forward, you just press it and then the seats is move automatic forward. It's just incredible how easy it is to do that. I like that. But now let me put everything back in the position. Okay, just like that. Also you have Isofix here, 2 Isofix, you can install 2 child seats and 2 in the back, so you can have 4 kids in this car without any problem. As I said, big entrance, a lot of space on the legs, also great visibility from this angle on the glass roof. Behind the front seats you have some plastic, some storage space here to put your stuff, actually 2 storage space, you have a net and you have another one, so really interesting. I like that. Also here in the middle you have those vents, unique and nice vents that Kia bring it on Sorento, and I love it, one of my favorite vents. They feel good quality and they look super nice, and also the air will go in many directions super easy. Love this part. Down here USB 12 volt port, very useful those days. Going inside, look how easy I go inside because of this flat entrance. Let me go here, let me put this back as well. And then, so just like that. Now I put everything all over in the back, close the doors. Oh yeah, close the door. The sound insulation in the car, it's also very good. I noticed that from the previous version, not the plug-in hybrid, the normal version. And look at this, you tell me, how is the space here? I have a window here also. I have this huge window here. I have soft and leather everywhere on my hand, on my back, these beautiful design seats. As I told you before, it's just, they are so incredible and they are so soft and nice. Very beautiful design and also super comfy. Love them. Oh man, I love this space. One of my favorite place to be in the back, in a car. One of the most comfortable car in the back. It's super, super nice. You have to try it. Space on my head, yeah, it's more than enough. I don't even need to worry about that. Space on my legs, even though, look at this, this is just crazy. Even down there I can stretch up a little bit the legs. So in terms of space, no problem. Very good quality also on the roof here, the material, it's incredible good. Also You have a hook, you have LED lights here, handle, very useful. Here in the middle, you have cup holder, leather as well. Very useful. Also in the middle, you have some space. If we go in the middle, you don't have any transmission tunnel. I can play right there with the legs, so simple and nice. And also I have huge space on my knees. Ah, by the way, guys, check this out. You have an USB here, and you have a 12 volt port here. And you have another USB here in this front driver seat, and then you have another here behind this one. How cool is that? And also you can control and play with the person in front seat if you want to adjust it in every position you want. How cool is that? You can play with his seat. Not a great idea, but when the kids are here in the back and they play with your seats, it's not so nice, but still, yeah, great option, great, great feature. Plenty of space on my legs, just like that. A lot of space on my head, no problem. Stretch my hand completely, free people. That means free people here, long trips, no problem. I mean, yeah, it's so, so nice. And with this glass roof, oh yeah, I cannot replicate what I see right now, or maybe I can. You can see something, it's just incredible. Look at the sky. Staying here, phenomenal. Anyway, we will go in the front. We will talk a little bit about the new multimedia system, the new cockpit, the center console, the things right there in the front. But I have to tell you, the design, it's unique. The vents are incredible nice. I love the vents. I'm a big fan of these vents. I like very much how they integrate the dashboard there and the cockpit and the multimedia system. Everything look incredible nice, and I'm a big fan of this car, to be honest. Let's go in the front, guys. Right, guys, before we go inside, here in the front you have a big window, and then you have a small one from two pieces, because in this way they can fold down all the way the windows, but the visibility from the interior when you drive, it's quite good, so you don't have to worry. Also you have big mirrors, great visibility. Soft material on the upper side, the same as in the back, same handle. This time here, those snakes design are LED lights. Not sure if you can see it, but they look super nice in the nighttime. It's a unique design, and I love the idea. Also, the buttons to position to save the electric seats. Then you have leather here, leather, very good quality, and also here. And then chrome design, glossy plastic, the buttons for the windows here. Then you have the lock and unlock. Adjustable mirrors, electric adjustable mirrors, look really premium and nice, this area. Some light reflectors here, some storage space, a lot of storage space, Bose sound system down here. So overall, very good quality, the same as in the back. Sorento logo at the entrance, aluminum pedals. Here is the fuse box, keep in mind. And then if you go up a little bit, you have the button to open the trunk, you have the traction control on and off, you open the gas tank from here. And then you have the position for the lights here to adjust it. Down here you have all the controls for the seats, electric adjustable seats, guys. From here you can adjust the position of your seats in every single position you want. And if you look at those seats, the same as in the back, phenomenal quality, beautiful design, unique and comfort. They didn't try too much to be sporty, they tried to make it comfortable as possible, and still have some side supports here if you go some sporty. And yeah, they are nice, and I like those design. And look how soft they are in the middle, beautiful design. They are wide, they are long, they are perfect, they are super comfy. You have to try it. Now going forward, as I said before, I like very much those vans design idea. Everybody try now to make small vans just like that, just a line like Tesla, just like these vans in the future. But you know, Kia said, okay, Sorento will come with some big nice vans and good quality vans, and they look nice, they are interesting, and if you feel it, if you push it, they are quite cool. And also you can send the air in every direction you want. So what do you think about that, guys? I'm really curious. I like them, not bad. Now, soft material all over the dash here, all over the dash, it's soft. That's something to keep in mind. Also, you have speaker there in one speaker in the middle. So overall, pretty good. Also, you can adjust the steering wheel from here, manual, forward, backward, up, down, how you want it. You can adjust it. Let me go inside, close the door. You have another speaker on the A pillar. right here, and then speaker here, speaker in the middle, speaker there, a lot of speakers, so the sound system, it's crazy good. Overall, if you look from here, you can see the design and the way they designed the door, integrated the door with the dash. It's quite nice and I like it very much. Now let's talk a little bit about the head-up display, because this time it's a premium head-up display. It's directly on the windshield and I love the way it looks. Colors, information there, I will give it a 10 from 10. Love the way it looks. It's very visible and nice, and yeah, great job. I will really recommend you to get it. Now up here you have a big mirror and some normal bulb light. Not sure why they don't have an LED light, but I like the fact that you have this huge mirror here. That's a big plus for the car. Also the mirror in the middle, you have good visibility in the back there, quite nice, easy to adjust. Up here you have some LED lights, like a touch screen, you have to put your finger there. Yeah, you can see it right now. And also you have the controller for the light and controllers for the SOS button, by the way. And then you have this controller for the glass roof. So for example, you can open this glass roof, and let's see how much you can open it. Oh yes, this is maximum, but pretty big entrance. Here also you have the insect protection, and then yeah, if you can close it, you have also that protection, that light curtain that you can put it, you can close it up, put it up or close it up. I will leave it open because I love to have a lot of light inside the car. Visibility around the windows, guys, it's really good visibility in the mirrors. Yeah, it's quite okay. You can see, you can make an idea from here. I don't have any complaint, you know. If I have some complaint, I will tell you, but it's quite good. Now, soft material here, actually it's leather with stitches. Huge space here, actually it's incredible big, where you can put so many things there. Very practical. And another space here where you can put your key, for example. Then you have another space where I have the key right now here, two cup holders. Very practical. The center console look really nice. It's practical and nice. You have some plastic on the side, but it doesn't matter, to be honest. You have chrome glossy plastic here. You have plenty of features, safe feature, and I love it. For example, the car comes with electronic handbrake, auto hold, downhill assist. Those are the parking sensors. This button here activate the 360 degrees cameras, so you can see around the car what's happening when you park the car. Also you can go in reverse. If you go in reverse, guys, let me show you. If you go in reverse, you can see even the lines, so you can see the lines on the ground, so you can park even easier with those lines. So that's something to keep in mind. Then you have the EV or plug-in or hybrid mode. So you press this button, you will go in EV or hybrid mode. Right now is the low battery, so it will not let you be in the hybrid mode, because after all the battery will be low. So you can see also you have this energy flow in the middle there, graphic that looks what happened with the battery, what happened with the engine right now. Heated steering wheel, a lot of premium features that if you want to buy a Mercedes or another car with a lot of features that this Sorento come, you will pay over 100,000 for sure. Now here in the middle you have the same system as on the Hyundai, the new system on the Hyundai Tucson or Santa Fe. You press this button here and you have two options, terrain and drive. On the drive mode you have Eco, Sport and Smart, you can see right here. And then if you press it on terrain, you have snow, mud and sand. How cool is that? And also you can see on the screen every time you change the driving mode. By the way, the car comes also with this new digital cockpit, and then it's much nicer than the previous one. You have a lot of infos there. Now you have Eco, Sport and Smart. Every time you change those settings, those driving modes, you will see that the graphic is changing, going in terrain, going snow mode, mud or sand. And also in the same time it will change a few stuff. We will actually stay in eco mode for now. Then I like very much this gear shifter transmission. Is the same one as Ford use, for example. These days you press the brake and then you go left and right, drive, neutral, reverse and parking, you press this button so you go. It's super simple to use it. I like it very much. It's the same one as Ford use it on automatic transmission these days. Other than that, here you have a huge space where you can charge your phone wireless right there. That's great. And you have two USB ports, actually three USB ports. How many USB ports have this car? Three in the front, three in the back. It's incredible. Really incredible. Then here you have heated seats and ventilated seats. How cool is that, guys? Ventilated seats, that means these little holes here get air outside in the summer, so you get not get sweat under your trousers. That's nice. That's a nice feature. I love it. So great job, great job. Start engine button, it's here behind the steering wheel. Then you have those vents here, the same nice vents as on the side. And then up here you have this climatic system, kind of a touchscreen buttons. If you look from the side, they are not physical button in the middle. Those here are physical button on the side, but in the middle they are kind of a touch button. So yeah, that's something to keep in mind. But other than that, I like it, to be honest, very much. You can synchronize, you have only driver only if you want to save some energy to the car. So it's a great system, simple to use and great. I like it.
Glove box, it's quite big. You have a normal bulb light there, so maybe the only bulb light inside this car. I didn't find other, maybe, yeah, this one here, two bulb light inside the car. Other than that, everywhere it's LEDs. So yeah, the glove box, it's quite big. Now here you have soft material, keep in mind soft. You have ambient light under here, you can see it right now. And then you have this snake skin design on the dash. Beautiful, beautiful design. I love the way it looks. And overall, it's nice. I like very much also how they integrate this multimedia system with glossy plastic, black and nice glossy, and then continuing to the screen also here in the middle. I like very, very much the way they design it and the way it looks. To be honest, also the cockpit there, you can control it from here. You can change a few, you can see a few information there from here, from those controllers on the steering wheel. It's not so customizable as you have on the Mercedes or Volkswagen, but still you can customize in many ways. And the screen have a great resolution, great quality and brightness, and colors look nice. So you have here a lot of infos, eco mode, driving mode. You can see information about all wheel drive, about the traction, about the range, how much range the battery have, zero for example right now. Here is the energy flow, what happened. Here is the consumption and attention level. Then you can change that. Can see the adaptive cruise control, can see the information about the navigation system. And other than that, also on the left side you can see what happened right now, eco power, what happened with the energy of the car right now. The steering wheel, great grip, amazing steering wheel, very good quality, guys. As you touch it, incredible good quality, I should say. I like it very much. Also, even the stalks behind the steering wheel look very nice and fancy. You have pedals to have some fun with the car if you want to change manual. Other than that, good quality glossy plastic. It's a premium steering wheel. I like it. Also, I like those buttons. How easy it is to push those buttons here, guys. To be honest, it's incredible easy to use them and to push them, and the quality of the buttons are incredible good. On the other side you have the cruise control and all the settings for the driving mode here. So very nice and very simple to control and to adjust different stuff while you are driving. Let's talk a little bit about the multimedia system. This is the new multimedia system that Kia uses. Also is the same one, almost the same one as Hyundai. And here on the side you have shortcut buttons that get you in different options. For example, setup, you press the setup, it will get you in the setup of the multimedia system. I have a video special with this multimedia system on my channel, Kia Multimedia System 2021. Check it out, guys, don't miss it. You will find out there all the information. Let's start with the beginning. So as I said, shortcut buttons, it get you to the map, get you to the settings, get you to the radio, get you to the media. If you want to go in the menu, you have up here home, for example, you press this home button. This is home. On the home screen, you have 1, 2, 3 pages. So 3 pages. On the first one, you have plug-in hybrid information here. This is unique
where you see how much energy you have, every range, charging manager, eco driving, energy flow. You can see you have history here. You have so many information about the car, energy flow. You can see what happened right now with the energy. You can see battery information, how much time you need to charge. Here you can see how many kilometers you can still drive with the battery that you have. So none right now because it's none, but pretty cool. Then you have the map here. You already see it before. The map, it's the latest one. It's gorgeous. I mean, it's one of the best, very bright, very nice. You have a 3D map or 2D map, the way you want to see it. It's very easy to use. You can choose a destination. It gives you a few options to arrive there. For example, once you set the destination, it's calculate pretty fast and it gives you two options, two alternatives to go there or free, depend where you go. So it's awesome. Then you have the climatic system where you can also change and control different functions, media, sound of nature, you know it from my other videos. And then on the settings here, you have also the vehicle settings where you find a lot of information about the car, driver assistance systems. From here you can activate and deactivate lane assist, parking safety, blind spot technology, all that stuff. Driving on terrain, here you can also change the different information and settings. Then you have the eco vehicle, start coasting, coasting guidance, how you want to have it. Then you have head-up display, cluster, instrument cluster, climatic seats, lights, door convenience and stuff like that. There are so many settings here, guys, but I get in more detail in the other video, in the multimedia system video. And here you have system, language, units, and yeah, you can change those settings from here, pretty simple. Other than that, it's the way it is. And yeah, for more infos about this multimedia system, check out the other video. So guys, what can I say? Overall, you have a good visibility on the cockpit, on the multimedia system, on the head-up display and outside. So it's a great car, in my opinion, one of the best car in this class, best quality price. That's the way it is. I mean, of course, Mercedes make amazing cars in this class, also BMW or Porsche or yeah, other brands. But when we talk about price, what do you offer? Kia, Hyundai, they are in top. So guys, that was the video. Thank you for watching. I will leave the link in the description to the car at Emil Frey in Bern, so you can check them out. If you're around here in Switzerland, you can call them, you can come here, you can test drive the car, you can see it. They will help you. Also, don't forget to subscribe to see the test drive, to see the newest car that will come on my channel. Also like it and share it if you find it useful, if you get some useful information from this video. And thank you very much to all of you that are watching my video. I really appreciate that, guys. Really appreciate to all my subscribers, to all my views. Also ask me anything, I will answer to you. Just comment down below. I will try my best to help you, to give you more infos and help you to make a decision if you want to buy a car. And guys, don't forget to check out our website, sdadancar.com. There you find a lot of articles about the car, videos, information about how to buy a secondhand car, a new car, what is plug-in hybrid, what is hybrid, what is mild hybrid. There you find all those answers. Go and read it. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and see you soon in the next one. Bye, guys.